Stothert here, who is chairman of the Omaha Streetcar Authority. Nick Statham, Nick, who is associate vice president and senior project manager at HDR and also the project manager for Omaha Streetcar Consultant. That's a mouthful. You're busy. Matt Tondell is the senior vice president at HDR, public works director Bob Stubbe, and planning director Dave Fanslaw. Greater Omaha Chamber and CEO, president and CEO Heath Mello is here. Thank you for being here. And Steve Jensen, who is, where did he go? Who is former planning director, who is now deputy chief of staff for economic development in my office, and many others that have been involved in the Omaha Streetcar project. We have completed the 30% design of the Omaha's modern streetcar. This morning, we're going to show you conceptual designs for the stations at 16 streetcar stops, the vehicle maintenance facility, and the power stations that will be built along the route. The planning department has reviewed the design and has recommended approval by the Urban Design Review Board. City code requires the Urban Design Review Board's review and approval of projects that are related to public buildings or streetscapes at the early stage of design. The board will meet on November 16th. During the 30% design process, a recommendation was made to modify the route. The western end, the western terminus, is now proposed at 39th Street and Farnham on the west side, the west terminus, instead of 42nd Street. And the 10th and Capitol on the north, or at 10th and Capitol on the north in the first phase of construction. The changes will allow the University of Nebraska Medical Center to complete the evaluation of the streetcar extension through their campus and potentially to the Saddle Creek campus. Moving the stop to 10th and Capitol allows, rather than 10th and Cass, allows for options for future extensions up north. These changes will require approval from the Omaha Streetcar Authority. HDR is designing our streetcar system, and Nick Statham, who is here, will now explain some of the features. Nick?
Thank you, Mayor. Good morning. As the mayor mentioned, we want to walk you through a sampling of some of the slides that will be presented to the Urban Design Review Board coming up next week. The first image we see here is a typical side stop. This location is at 26th and Farnham. The mayor mentioned there's going to be 16 stops on the route. The majority, 13 of the stops, will be a side stop. So this is kind of a typical configuration of what those will look like. A couple of key features that we want to highlight with this stop. First of all, the dimensions. They're approximately 100 feet long, and they're 8 feet wide. They're going to sit within parking trays along the existing roadway corridor, so they'll actually come out from the sidewalk. Those will have some definition between the sidewalk behind and the stop itself, with some landscape buffers or some other streetscape elements that you can see there on the image. The idea is that it separates the sidewalk. People that are walking up and down the street can continue to do so. Access to businesses is maintained. And then the streetcar riders will be out a little bit out into the street. The platform itself will have a raised center section. You can see that in the image in the middle. That allows for level boarding, ADA compliant level boarding. So that's a roll-off, roll-on boarding scenario. We'll talk about that a little bit more when we talk about the vehicle update. The shelters shown in the middle of that stop are conceptual right now. We'll have some more detail in a moment. But the idea is to have a small shelter in the middle of the platform to help give some definition to the space and have a place for people to sit as they wait for the car. We're also looking at having real-time arrival signs at the stops. So that sign is shown there, that small white image. That would provide a next train arrival information to folks that are on the platform. Next slide. The next image here is a sample of our center platforms. So three of those 16 stops will be a center platform. They'll be located between Turner and 37th in the Midtown and Blackstone areas. The reason why the design team pivoted to these center stops, a couple of reasons. One, with the grades in these areas, the center stop gave us some more flexibility to tie the platform into the surrounding geometry of the roadway. The second, there's some narrower sidewalks, especially within Blackstone, so having these center platforms helps to alleviate that pressure on those sidewalks. The roadway section through these areas is predominantly a three-lane section, so one lane in each direction and a center turn lane. So these center platforms will take the space of that shared center turn lane where they're located. So a couple of elements to call out in this image. This particular image is at 34th and Farnham. So access to the platforms will be through crosswalk locations. That also helps to shorten the crossing length for people getting on and off the streetcar. Provide some traffic calming to the corridor as well. Once they enter that center median location, then they can walk up a ramp and get to that same elevated level boarding section that we talked about for the side stop locations. Shelters on these stops would likely be two-sided with overhead canopies facing in either direction. And these stops as well would have real-time arrival signs, one for each direction. These stops would be a little bit wider than the side stops, between 12 and 14 feet wide. That would allow boarding, active boarding on both sides of the platform. So one platform will serve both eastbound and westbound streetcars at the same location. Next slide. So here's a conceptual image of what the shelters may look like. The project will go out for an RFP for the shelters later in the design phase. So the actual definition of that shelter will be dependent on the selected vendor. There are numerous vendors out there that can offer a shelter similar to this. The key aspects of the shelter would be an overhead canopy, providing that coverage. The backing, we're looking at a perforated metal back wall to have some separation from the sidewalk behind. That back wall would allow for placement of signage or other images on the wall. And then sidewalls for some wind protection, and then bench seating within the shelter itself. Next slide, please. So switching gears. This is our maintenance facility, current conceptual rendering. So this facility is located in the existing Lot A of the Mecca facility. The maintenance facility is approximately 36,000 square feet. It is a two-story building. The first floor of the building is predominantly set aside for vehicle maintenance, streetcar vehicle maintenance. There will be three bays where the vehicles are able to enter the maintenance facility. Perform routine maintenance, heavy overhaul maintenance, as well as a vehicle wash facility. The upper floor of the building will be predominantly reserved for administrative space, offices, conference facilities, training facilities for the streetcar authority and their staff. The facility will be secure, fenced, and will also allow for additional vehicle storage outside of the building. So at the end of the day, all six vehicles within the fleet will be stored here at this facility. This next image is an example of our traction power substation, TPSS for short. The system will have three of these along the route. What these do is convert AC power from the grid to DC power that will feed the overhead lines for the system. The project has gone through a load flow analysis. We are looking at a hybrid off-wire, on-wire system. So the locations of these substations was developed based on that analysis. And where we'll have the wire, where we will not have the wire. The current design has three locations for these substations. One is at Turner and Farnham, which is the image we're seeing here. Another is at 24th and Farnham. And the last location is at 16th and Douglas. Want to highlight for this image here, the structures themselves are roughly 15 by 30 feet in dimension, 8 to 10 feet tall. Again, they'll be vendor-driven once we go out for RFPs at the end of the design phase. That will change the dimensions slightly. For this image here, we're looking at adding a brick facade to the building, help it blend into its surroundings a little bit better. Also look to have some landscape buffers. This location is on the western side of the green space on the west side of Turner. So as you can see, our intent is to make that blend into the surroundings, kind of disappear within the streetscape once it's constructed. So these images here are some examples we received earlier this year from potential vendors for our streetcar, modern streetcar. A couple of key aspects for the bid, which is currently out on the street. We are looking for six modern streetcars for the vehicle fleet. The actual length of the streetcars will vary depending on the vendor, but we're looking at lengths between 16 to 80 feet long. All of the vehicles will be 8 foot 8 inches wide. They will also allow for level boarding. So the center doors for all of these vehicles have level boarding mechanisms in them. So as they pull up to the stop, they're able to meet ADA boarding requirements at that platform. Again, it's a roll-on, roll-off situation for folks using the stop. They are also going to be a hybrid traction power system. So these vehicles are able to operate both on-wire and off-wire. The off-wire segments will use onboard battery storage within the vehicles. That battery will be charged as the vehicle is operating in an on-wire section. There will also be some charging infrastructure at each ends of the alignment to allow for rapid charging when the vehicle does its switchover. But using the onboard energy storage, we're able to run approximately 40% of the alignment off-wire. Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Now, Nick will be available as well as others for questions after we are finished here. But after the review by the Urban Design Review Board, the design also will require approval from the Omaha Streetcar Authority. Jay Noddle is the chairman of the authority, and I wanted to ask Jay to come forward and say a few words.
Oops. Thank you, Mayor. Good morning, everyone. It's nice to be here this morning. On behalf of the Omaha Streetcar Authority, I would just like to say we're excited to be here today. This is really the community's first opportunity to see images that are a product of a tremendous amount of work that the design team has been undertaking. There will be more events like this as time goes on and as the details of other parts of the project become more clear and are ready for to show to the community. The project is on schedule, and as Nick and the mayor have both mentioned, there will be some approvals that the Streetcar Authority Board is asked to provide as we work through the next couple months. So thank you very much, and I'd be happy to answer any questions when the time comes.
Thank you, Jay. HDR is now working on the 60% design, and that is expected to be complete by the end of the year. Other important updates. Advertisements for bids for the purchase of the modern streetcar were published November 1st. The Omaha Streetcar Authority plans to buy 6 cars. Bids will be open January 24th, with the selection of the car maker expected in February of 2024. Bid highlights include the length of the cars, width and capacity, the ADA required level boarding, and off-wire capability for up to 40% of the route. We have talked often about extending the initial streetcar route. We have applied for a $300,000 federal grant through the U.S. Department of Transportation to study an extension to North Omaha. This route will connect riders to jobs, education, and services, and create commercial and mixed-use developments and affordable housing along the route. The city will provide a 50% local match through a combination of funding and in-kind support. And finally, we showed you the station design for the streetcar stops. This month, future streetcar boarding zone signs, do we have those here? There they are, right there, will be installed at all of those locations so that you could see actually where they are going to be. The signs also, as you can see, they include a QR code so that you can learn more about the boarding zones. So that's our presentation today, and like I said, we have a lot of folks here that have been involved in the planning, and we are all here to answer your questions. I'm sure Nick is going to get most of them, so.
Mayor, I assume that Nebraska Medicine was involved in the early planning stages. So what has changed that's going to change the route, the starting point? And secondly, is this going to affect the overall initial cost of the streetcar?
Well, okay, the initial cost and the cost that we are still dealing with is what we just talked about right now, that is under construction, will be under construction, that the city will be responsible for. If Nebraska Medicine and HDR has been working with Nebraska Medicine, if they decide to move the streetcar into their campus, they have not decided yet where and which route and what it'll look like, and so we decided we would stop it a little further east than bring it up to 42nd Street because we're really not sure what design that they will actually settle on if they are going to move it into their campus. Now, if they do, that cost will be to the Nebraska Medical Center and to University of Nebraska. That won't be a cost to the city of Omaha if it moves into their campus.
Mayor, Mr. Noddle mentioned that the project is on schedule. Wasn't there some delay in announcing the last half a dozen months or so?
I don't recall any delay.
Something got pushed back?
Not that I can recall.
Joe, it may be that...
Once you, you know, if you answer, we'll probably need to come up.
Yeah.
There really hasn't been any delay in the schedule of the project. There may be a number of things that have been put into a little bit of a different sequence as we've gone through the process, and more importantly, as HDR and the Public Works Department have gone through the process. There were things that the sequence was just changed a little bit, but overall, we're on schedule.
Mm-hmm. And that schedule always has been that we were planning on starting construction in the spring of 2024, and I think, Jay, correct me if I'm wrong, but we are still on schedule to hopefully start construction in the spring of 2024 with completion in 2026.
Yeah, I might just add to that. The mayor's absolutely right. There will be utility work and things below grade that need to happen first. So those things will start as soon as really the weather permits in the spring. And we won't have actual streetcar route or rail construction for a little bit after that, because the work below ground's got to happen first.
Mm-hmm. And I want to stress again the reason that we wanted to give you this presentation today is because it is required, city code requires, after 30% design, which we have completed, that it goes to the Urban Design Review Board, and it has already been approved by the Planning Board. So then it goes to Urban Design Review Board. Our next milestone will be 60%, and then it'll go to 90%. And that's just how the design goes. Remember, once again, this is nothing new. We have been talking about a streetcar in Omaha for about 20 years now. So it's really good to see it finally happening and materializing. But things are going very, very well.
Mayor, will there be advertising on the actual streetcars themselves or at the stops or anything like that?
You know, Jay, I'm going to ask Jay to come up again, but I will say we don't want advertising on the outside of the streetcars. There could be some on the inside of the cars, and there could be some also on the stations, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is typical throughout the country with similar type projects for there to be branding opportunities inside the cars maybe, but more appropriately where the stops are. And certainly only on a very special occasion, any kind of a wrap or anything on the exterior. But that would be something that would be very limited and have to be truly a special occasion for that to happen.
Keep in mind, too, those streetcars that which we're talking about made me think about this, is the bids have gone out. There's one manufacturer in the United States. The others are European. And so, you know, they will vary from 100, 20, 150 people per car. They're very expensive. I average around $6 million each. We need to buy six. So this is a big step forward that we are going to go forward and order these cars, because it takes a couple years, doesn't it, once you order them.
Any revenue that would come out of the advertising, that goes to the city, the general fund?
The revenue, that would go... That
would go back into operations.
Okay. I'm going to ask Bob Stubbe, because I want to make sure that I don't make an error in what I'm saying.
So the construction of the streetcar will come from bonds. Operation of the streetcar will come from the parking and mobility division. So when you pay for parking, whether it's in garages or whether it's at the meters, that revenue that's generated will be used to pay for the annual O&M related to the streetcar.
Including revenue from advertising.
Absolutely. That will all go into that enterprise fund.
Okay. Other questions? You could stick around, Bob.
You bet.
I want Bob to stick around, because you got to keep in mind this too. This is a City of Omaha project. It's a public works project. And so Bob is the director of the Public Works Department.
Mayor, I wanted to piggyback off what Tom said earlier. So this kind of what takes away six or seven blocks by narrowing the route, doesn't that save taxpayers? Doesn't that save money?
Oh, well, it of course it will. I mean, it'll save money, but that's not the entire reason we're doing it. You know, we've always talked that this is the initial route. And when we first started talking about it, we thought, you know, 10th Street to 42nd Street. But as the design went on and then understanding other interests, including the Med Center, you know, we've always talked about, could we expand it to North Omaha? Could one of these days it go to the airport? You know, all of these things are under consideration, but you got to look at this as the initial route. So when the Med Center showed a lot of interest in bringing that and a lot of value for the streetcar to be going into their campus, we decided not, when they did not know where it would probably make a turn or how it would go into their campus, it made a lot of sense to stop at 39th Street and let that discussion between HDR and the Med Center continue until they decide. But we can always expand it. That's the beauty of it. But of course, the smaller it is or the shorter the tracks are, it does save money, but that's not the only reason we're doing it.
So UNMC is on the hook for whatever it goes past 39th?
If UNMC wants it to go into their campus, then they will fund it. It wouldn't be funded through the City of Omaha with the funding model that we are using. Yes.
Correct. To extend into North Omaha, you mentioned a $300,000 study. If that were to happen, is the idea to pay for that the same process as paying for the original streetcar, the development along the route?
You know, it probably not. And in fact, if we would extend it into North Omaha or maybe even one of these days to the airport, it's more likely that we will be using some federal funds, which we are not using for the initial route. But federal funds take a long time to apply for and to get. And so we are starting to plan right now.
Would any of that expansion come to the taxpayers?
Well, you know, right now we don't know. I mean, hopefully not. We don't know. We haven't even looked at it. We're just applying for a grant right now to look into the possibility of expanding it. But we certainly, you know, what we've said for the initial route is we figured out a funding model that did not require any type of a tax increase, and that's what we're sticking to. Jay, did you want to make a comment?
Yeah, I would just add, thank you. Any required funding for extensions beyond the initial route, particularly if there is a federal study that we're able to have happen, any future funding would be part of that study. So that'll come back and say whatever it says, but presumably it'll say we think the system ought to be expanded and here's where, here are the likely costs, and here is the funding model for that piece of expansion.
All right. Other questions?
I had a question about the wire, the on-wire and off-wire operations. Do you guys know yet where the car will be on-wire and where it will be off-wire?
Yeah.
Yes. Based on the load flow study that we did for the 30% design, we have those regions defined, and those have been part of our car builder bid documents as well. They are subject to change once we have a selection with the final car and that car's requirements, but we do have the general zones identified. So just, you know, broadly speaking, on the eastern end of the alignment and near the park would be off-wire. Most of the downtown section would be on-wire. Once we go up the hill at Midtown, the uphill section would be on-wire, downhill's off-wire, and then Blackstone would be predominantly off-wire.
But all the cars can operate both on and off.
Correct. That's a requirement of the bid documents.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys have a preference in the bids you've seen so far for streetcars, or is it too early to tell?
We haven't received any formal bids yet, so we'll let the process play out and see what proposals we receive.
Mm-hmm. Can you talk about the input you guys are doing there? Like, are you guys going to places that have these designs of streetcars? Like, what, are you guys visiting cities at all just to get a better idea of the streetcars that...
Sure. So the City of Omaha and the OSA is a member of the Community Streetcar Coalition, as an example. They do have summits around the country, and city staff have participated in some recent summits in Milwaukee and Oklahoma City.
Mm-hmm. If you go back to that slide, I don't know if you can, that shows the four streetcars. There you go. Nick can tell you where these are from. You
sure.
Want to point out just for your interest here.
Yeah, and again, these are all images received by the car builders earlier this year. The upper left is from Brookville. That is a U.S.-based manufacturer. The upper right is from Stadler. They're European. And the two bottom images are two examples from CAF. So CAF, which are European, CAF is currently running in Kansas City and Cincinnati. Stadler does not have a U.S. streetcar currently, but they have a lot of streetcars and trams in Europe. And then Brookville is in a number of systems across the country. Milwaukee, Oklahoma City, Detroit, Dallas, some examples, Tempe.
Do you expect bids from all four?
We expect numerous bids. It's an open process, so we'll see what we receive.
I've seen several different color schemes up here. Are those examples that we might see, or have you decided or thought about a color scheme at this point?
We have not. These images were provided by the car builders, so their artistic license is their own. They've prepared that themselves. Branding would be a future step of the OSA and the streetcar team, and that will help define the look of the cars as we go forward.
What about parking? It seems like it's great if you're living in Blackstone. You can just walk to one of the stops. But if you out west, you want to use the streetcar, is there a place to park in the area for them to be able to use the streetcar?
Yes. So the city has numerous parking facilities along the route. Director Stubbe mentioned, parking revenues is part of the O&M payment method for the streetcar system. So connecting people coming from other parts of Omaha to the route, finding parking, and then getting onto the streetcar is part of the operating philosophy of the system.
Mm-hmm. For example, the city of Omaha will be purchasing the three parking garages that are currently at Midtown. And so the city will own and operate them. So, you know, if I live out in West Omaha, I could drive, park there, hop on the streetcar, take it all around wherever I want, bet downtown, go back to where my car is parked at Midtown.
Mayor, I know you've been having town halls. What do you tell people who maybe still aren't sold on a streetcar?
You know, thanks for the question, Alex. I've had 7 town hall meetings. The streetcar, surprisingly to me, wasn't a major topic or a question that people were asking us in all 7 city council districts. However, I will tell you that Steve Jensen, who works in my office as an economic developer, former planning director, he and I are, we're out on the road doing a 30-minute PowerPoint presentation about the streetcar. And I always ask at the beginning, how many of you have heard of the streetcar? Well, of course, everybody has. How many support it? It's a mixed bag. After we present it and show them the value of it, why we're doing it, how we're paying for it, and how it could be a great benefit to downtown Omaha, to the urban core, and everybody in Omaha, at the end, I will say, now who supports the streetcar? And usually, and Steve will agree with me, it's usually the majority of people there, if not everybody. So I think it's a matter of, we hope we can get out and do this more and more and explain how we're doing it, why we're doing it, what it's going to look like, what the value is, how we're going to pay for it, and that it won't require a tax increase. Then people say, I get it now. And I think it's really important, and Steve does such a good job of explaining what we have downtown now. And we have, come up here, Steve, because he will say 50% of downtown is surface parking lots, and at any given time they're half full. And so, you know, we would much rather trade those surface parking lots for buildings and businesses and jobs, and that's one of the great benefits of the streetcar. Do you want to add into that?
I think you've said it well. About 50% of the developable land in downtown is devoted to parking. And about half of that parking is vacant at any given point in time. So you have the opportunity to build billions of dollars worth of development on those now somewhat vacant parking lots, which is our goal.
Mm-hmm.
So we've looked at the projections, and if we continue down the path we have followed for the past 50, 60 years to accommodate the development that we anticipate coming to the urban core, we would need about 50,000 more parking stalls, half of which would sit vacant most of the time. And so on the blocks that would be consumed by those parking stalls would consume about 40 square blocks with nothing but 6-story tall parking garages that pay nothing in taxes. Those same 40 square blocks would hold about $2 billion worth of development that would be taxable. So that's part of the goal.
And already the streetcar hasn't even began construction, and we have approximately $1 billion worth of development that wouldn't have happened without the streetcar. And that is Mutual of Omaha's new skyscraper downtown, and that includes Mutual of Omaha's old campus in Midtown. Both of those are being built, the new tower, redeveloped the current site Mutual has, and that together is almost $1 billion worth of new development that would not happen without the streetcar. Our group went out, they visited other cities, they've studied other cities, and every city that we have visited that has built a streetcar, the development that occurred around the route has exceeded what the original estimates were.
Mayor, you haven't said yet if you're running for re-election.
No, I haven't.
If you thought the next mayor try to stop the streetcar, does that make you more likely to run?
You know, if I decide to run or not, it's not going to be based on the streetcar or who else is running or who my opponent can be. It will be a personal decision of mine, and I will make up that my mind, and I will announce after the first of the year.
After the first of the year?
After the first of the year, I certainly will.
Before February?
But I don't know. That's my birthday month. Why? Is that significant to you?
No,
it'll be after the first of the year. We got plenty. It's 17 months away. We've got plenty of time to decide. But I think whether anybody is going to run for mayor or not, that is a personal decision. But for the voters, that decision is who is the one that is going to keep the momentum going that we have now so we can continue to meet the goals that we have been meeting. That's what the voters are going to be concerned with.
Have any concern that voters might
want to
stop the streetcar?
Well, no, I don't.
Why the first of the year?
Well, it's 17 months away. You know, I look when I've run three times before, and for me, there's no hurry to announce at all. I got a big job to do right now, and I'm really busy with it, and so I will certainly make up my mind and let everybody know, but it's not going to be before next year. Other questions?
Back to the streetcar. We've seen crews out working to find the utility lines. Is there any sort of update on that and where they're at
with that? Yes. Nick? Okay.
Yeah.
See, I want to have the right people answer these questions. So.
Yeah, we're looking to wrap up the potholing effort this week, actually.
And explain what you mean by that, please.
Sure. So, potholing. For the last year, we've been doing a lot of outreach with the utilities in the corridor, receiving their as-built drawings, surveying surface features, manholes, valves, those type of things. But as we work closer to finalizing design and starting construction, having some more understanding of what's happening below the pavement is very valuable. Helps with planning, helps with understanding what are truly conflicts versus what are utilities that might be able to remain as is, depending on their depth. So the project partners have identified over 600 locations where we wanted to have additional information about what the existing utility was, where it was actually located, and how deep. And so that program has been going for about the last month, a little more than the last month. And again, that's wrapping up here this week. So that information will be shared with our design team. It'll be shared with the utilities themselves so they can help make some decisions about their infrastructure needs going forward. Sure. I think by and large, the as-built information we had was fairly accurate, which is a good sign. Obviously, there's always some discrepancies, and that's why we went through the program. Getting better depth information has been very helpful. And then we found more information about the existing street, kind of the makeup of the street. It's quite a bit more varied than initially assumed. We found some of the old streetcar tracks, which is all helping to inform the design and that work phasing.
Well, HDR is working with independently from what the city of Omaha is doing. Do you want to comment, or Matt, do you want to comment? Okay, or Jay? I have a whole committee here today.
I can say this. I think we're very optimistic that the medical center would like to take advantage of the streetcar. I'm certain of that. Exactly where it goes, what route it takes, remains to be seen. As you all know, over the course of the last several weeks, more buildings have started on their campus, and those things all matter. It has to do with what side of the road it goes on, and you know, do we come down the hill, or you know, just which direction do we take? Does the route take? They're very engaged in this, and I believe that in the weeks ahead or the months ahead, probably, they'll pick a route that is ideal for them, and then there'll be a whole nother round of discussions relative to design, and they'll put their own funding plan together.
Is there a date at which the streetcar can't be stopped?
Boy, you are persistent this morning.
I know, I know. Can't be stopped. Well, you know, I've said this before, that all of the votes and the approvals that we needed to move forward with the streetcar have been done by the city council in open meetings. They also have already given approval for the finance director to start issuing bonds. And so at this point in time, no pun intended, it's full speed ahead. So it again, the votes that we needed to move forward have been done by the council. It does not, and I've said this many times, require a public vote. There will be no tax increase, no property tax, sales tax, new taxes, so it's not appropriate for a public vote. So things are moving ahead.
Just put a fine line on this. So we get to the spring election 2025. Obviously there's been construction done. Track might be laid, I don't know. Could the next mayor say, no, we're not going any further with this?
You know, I'll tell you, in my opinion, no. But then, look at the value is what we are talking about. I wouldn't even contemplate why somebody, when it was under construction, when a finance plan has been developed and it is underway, why somebody would come in and want to stop it. It would be beyond
my
comprehension.
Well,
you know, I don't know about that poll, because we're not, you know, those polls out there are not always accurate, Joe, and you know that. And so, you know, what a poll says now, like I said, if I talk to a group of people and I say, who supports the streetcar, and they half of them say they don't, and then when we get done explaining it, they do. I mean, that's the big difference. Think about this. You know, when we built the new ballpark, people were against it. I had people say, I will never go to another ball game. When we built the Arena Convention Center, waste of money. When we built the Dodge Expressway, don't need it. Not ever going to drive on Dodge anymore. When just most recently, the parks downtown, I had so many people write me and say, don't mess up the Jean Leahy Mall. I'll never go there again. The first weekend all three parks were open, August 18th weekend, they estimate over 75,000 people visited the park. People generally don't like to see change, and the first question they will ask is, how is this going to benefit me? And then they see, when it is completed, how it benefits them and how it improves the entire city and how it benefits the entire city. People love the new parks, and it will only make downtown Omaha better. So I look at the streetcar the same way. It's something new. It's something people haven't tried before. It's a lot of people out west will say, well, how am I going to use it unless it comes out to my neighborhood? And so I think once it is built and once people understand and enjoy it and see the benefit and see new jobs come into downtown and see new businesses come in, they're going to feel the same way they did about the ballpark, the Arena Convention Center, the Dodge Expressway, and the parks. And I could go on and on and on. That's what we're hoping. And, you know, I hate to put you on the spot, but Heath Mello is here, who's the new president of the Greater Omaha Chamber of Commerce, and what is their main focus is jobs and economic development and businesses. And I just want to know, maybe you would want to say a few things about downtown. I want to give you the opportunity, although I don't want to put you on the spot there.
Well, thank you, Mayor, for the opportunity to be here today. And as the mayor made a great argument that the Greater Omaha Chamber of Commerce has been making well before my time, which is Omaha needs to grow and Omaha needs to focus on the future. And part of that is the city's urban core master plan that was unveiled in roughly March 2022 that seeks to create 30,000 new jobs and bring 30,000 new residents to to the city's urban core. And I think you heard today, both from the mayor, I think from HDR, from Jay Noddles, the streetcar authority, that that plan is partially driven by the real opportunities that the modern streetcar bring day in and day out. So if we're going to be a city of the future, the modern streetcar is taking us there. And as I talk to CEOs every day across this city, as we're trying to recruit new companies to come to Omaha, they want an environment and they want an urban core that keeps and attracts young professionals and the talent of the future. And so I want to applaud Mayor Stothert, her administration, for taking bold leadership to see this through, to engage the community in sometimes tough conversations, and to win over converts. And the reality, which is if we're going to be a city of the future, as the mayor just said, we're going to have to progress, and this infrastructure project is truly going to be the lightning rod to be able to do that into the future.
You support the streetcar?
100%, Joe. I think this modern streetcar, before I came to the Greater Omaha Chamber in August, I got to spend some time in Kansas City, travel the Kansas City streetcar, and I can tell you, as someone with a young family who all my kids got to get on it, we got to travel the whole route, get off the tracks. It was a great experience, and I think that's exactly what the city has identified and seen as they've traveled and visited other streetcar cities, that this is something that brings people to urban cores, brings people and connects people to businesses. And I think to some extent, the Greater Omaha Chamber has been a huge supporter of this effort as part of our urban core work. But I think the mayor said this earlier, this is a conversation that once again, we'll keep having with anybody around Omaha, with the mayor, Steve Jensen, the chamber. We're there to help remind businesses and our members that while this is in the urban core, it's going to impact the entire city. And a strong urban core will drive our regional economy into the future.
When you ran for mayor, remember you were for it, then you were kind of against it?
You know what? I'll let him answer, but I'm going to answer first. We're not living in the past. I mean, you know, we know this. Cities never sit still. They either go forward, move forward, or they decline and fall behind. And we are not going to be one of those cities that is going to fall and decline and fall behind. So living in the past or anything that was said in the past is nothing that I even want to bring up right now. We got to live in where we are right today and move forward. Bring the city forward. Now,
I think the mayor said it perfectly.
Were
I think
you were wrong 4 years ago?
Joe, I've been wrong a lot in my life.
Yeah,
I can tell
so
you.
Have I. I know.
And I can tell you, the Greater Omaha Chamber has enjoyed a long-standing, productive, healthy relationship with the city, particularly with Mayor Stothert and her team. When I took over this role, any past statements, any past views I may have had, it was personal views I had in the past. The reality is this, is I'm 100% behind this project. The Greater Omaha Chamber is 100% behind this project. And part of my job in selling Omaha, not just to our companies and our residents here in the region, in selling Omaha to cities across the country, is this project. This project is part of that future that the mayor walked us through. And I'm proud to be part of her team and this effort to make sure that this project goes according to plan, not just in regards to the urban core, but selling this to companies and cities across the country.
Well, I don't know. Did you want to say something?
No, I'll let you go first.
No, it could be housing, and hopefully a lot is housing. You know, the great benefit when you're building housing there, and it doesn't affect single-family, multifamily, triplexes. It's only revenue-producing commercial property along the route that their value will go up because of the streetcar. Okay, so hopefully it will be some residential along there, because that's what we see along streetcar routes, because it can, you know, these people that say around the med center, they may not need a car at all. We know that a lot of the new tenants down at the brick line down on 10th Street, they're going to be working at the med center. Think about that. They can hop on the streetcar and take it down to the med center in the morning. And so it will be, but they'll be commercial too along the route. There always is. And it just makes it easier for people to get around. Now, we know a developer that owns a lot of property, probably west of 19th Street on Farnham on the north side. I got to stop and think. A lot of surface lots along there. He is waiting to see if we're going to do a streetcar. He said before, if we don't do a streetcar, he may build a couple-story apartment buildings along there because he has to spend a lot of money building parking and garages, too. If we put the streetcar along Farnham Street, he's going to build something much higher, maybe a 7 or 8 story building, because he doesn't have to build as much parking. He's going to take advantage of the streetcar. And that's where that residential along the streetcar route becomes so important. So, and of course, you know this before, but the amount of revenue that we are very confident that we will get along the streetcar route, and that's 3 blocks and then 6 blocks, will more than cover the cost of the construction of the streetcar. And the additional revenue can be used on other street projects like bike lanes, and it could be used for affordable housing.
Can I give you an opportunity to respond to that as well? What do you think of the development happening along the route?
I think the mayor captured it and captured it perfectly in the sense that we're looking at commercial and residential development across the entire urban core area. And I think that's the most important point that we shouldn't take our eyes off of, is that the city did their due diligence of ensuring that the financing model and mechanism would generate enough property valuation growth over a number of years, both in commercial and residential, to cover the cost and the construction of the streetcar. So yes, as a Greater Omaha Chamber, we want to see clearly more residential developments. I would reinforce there is a focus on market rate residential focus, though, in terms of growing in that base. The mayor is right. There's affordable units, workforce units as well incorporated. But the reality is that the top line component is the growth itself is what drives this opportunity. And we're excited to be able to see both commercial growth, but also the residential growth that clearly we want to see a densified urban core area. And the city's work is helping achieve that.
Let me bring up one other point here that I think is important to make. And that is, we want to attract new businesses, obviously, to Omaha. A challenge that we have in Omaha, which is a double-edged sword, and the state of Nebraska as a whole, is we have an extremely low unemployment rate. You know, you hear people say, if you don't have a job in Omaha, you're not looking very far, because there's jobs everywhere. We have such a low unemployment rate. So then we say, if we're going to bring new businesses in, are they going to look at what is our labor pool? Is there enough people that I can hire? So then we look at, what do young professionals want? What do these businesses want? Why would they move here? Well, let me tell you what they want. They want urban living, young professionals. They want walkability. They want public transportation. They want open spaces. They want entertainment. They want affordable housing. That is exactly what we are doing in our urban core. And that's what the Urban Core Committee focused on, and that's what we are doing now. So we are making this environment, especially in our urban core, more attractive to bring to businesses here, because they want to know if we have the we have the labor here that they can hire. And so that is exactly what our goal is. Yeah, you bet.
If the University of Nebraska Madison joins on the rear, we talked about the same hours, the possible systems here, 10 shifts at different times of day.
I think anything's possible. If you know that, and you know the hours of operation, is that what you said?
Yes.
You know, a lot of that depends on what's going on, the weather. You know, if there's College World Series and a lot going on downtown, they may be running later into the night than if it's, you know, 20 below and there's a blizzard outside. But certainly, if the Med Center decides to expand into their campus, you know, all of those things have not been decided yet. And so that work will continue. But we wanted to make our streetcar route in that Western Terminus in such a place that if they wanted to expand, they certainly can. But again, that will not be an additional cost to the city of Omaha. Other questions? You've all sat down, so I guess you're worn out right now. You got a lot of people here to answer questions if you have any more. All right, well, we'll wrap it up. Well, thank you all so much for being here today. I know you have the press release that we sent out. I think it's sent out. You all have copies of that. And so thank you all for coming today. Appreciate it.